Okay, so Rohan Brill here with New South Wales Department of Primary Industries based at Wagga. We're just at a canola trial here. We've got, as part of the Optimised Canola Profitability Project funded by GRDC and collaborative with CSIRO and SARDI. So we're here about 15 kilometres northwest of Wagga, so on the towards Coolman, so on a fairly intensive canola growing area. So some people around here getting up to around 50% canola in their rotation. So we're obviously pushing the need for a lot of nitrogen inputs in that rotation. One thing in our project, we've found that to date, a lot of the big driver of yield is just biomass. That by the time, once we get to maturity, biomass at maturity really correlates quite closely to grain yield. And we've actually had reasonably consistent harvest index. We've had more lower harvest index at low biomass levels. And so we've tried to really hone in on what's those big drivers of biomass and what is the big bang for the buck for biomass. So the first one of the aspects we're looking at is nitrogen, and we think that a lot of the crops around the region have been a bit underdone on nitrogen, and that's been one thing that's limited their biomass and limited the amount of water they've been able to uptake. So that's the first component that we've been looking at. So the old rules of thumb of canola are that the crop needs to have available around 80 kilos per hectare of nitrogen per tonne of grain targeted. So a lot of the crops around here where they've come in from, say, canola cereal type rotations, they might be down around 40 or 50 kilos of available nitrogen. And if we budget even on a conservative, say, 30 or 40 mineralisation, we're only, say, around that 80 kilos of available nitrogen. So even to get up to a 2.5 tonne of the hectare crop, we're looking at the inputs of, say, 120 kilos of nitrogen. So the requirements for crops are quite large around here. And that's one component we can see straight away. The canola, what some good growers are really starting to get canola in, trying to get it into a rotation that has higher nitrogen levels. So the old mixed farming systems was good for that, and canola often went after a pasture phase in that system when nitrogen levels were quite high. But in this paddock here, we've actually sown canola on the back of a faba bean crop from 2015. So that was with a particular aim to make sure that we didn't have a really deficient nitrogen situation to start with. So in this paddock, there was about 80 kilos a hectare of available nitrogen. Compared to that sort of district average of 40 or 50, that gives you a really good buffer and just doesn't require that big input of nitrogen as what's needed in the canola cereal rotations. We found that nitrogen can go on really at any time. So it can, it just depends on the system. There's no agronomic penalty to putting it on all up front, but the thing is that you're sort of putting all your eggs in one basket at the start. There is a risk management decision that you can delay some of that nitrogen to a little bit later on, maybe to about that early stem elongation stage. With some of these big rates, we do find that we do drop oil concentration. So that is quite consistent, that although the yield responses to nitrogen in canola are very consistent, the oil declines are also reasonably consistent as well. At some point that does cause an economic penalty, but usually we find that the yield benefits outweigh the loss in economic value of oil. So nitrogen still, with canola, yield is king.